And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Grixis mid-range in best of one. That's what we're going to be playing this in. We're going to be playing seven games in Mythic ranked best of one with it. See how it does. This is kind of just a nice Grixis mid-range deck that has just a whole bunch of different stuff. This is a list from one of the viewers in Discord that's been playing it quite a bit. Tuned to just a little bit for best of one. They've been playing it more best of three. But I'm excited to try it out. We just have like a lot of different like interaction and different cards that are pretty good, and we're gonna kind of see how it all comes together. I really like Mire Triton. I think Mire Triton is one of the strongest cards in the set. I think it's just it just helps turn on so many different archetypes. You know, it gives you life gain in black, the Death Touch. This is just a really solid card, and you know, it mills over two cards, and this deck is kind of about milling over some cards. We can use Enter the God Eternals to mill ourselves, Atreus, put some cards in the graveyard. Thought Erasure can do that, and of course, just playing a long game, we can get cards in the graveyard. The reason why that's valuable is because Lazav can turn into those cards in the graveyard, but then we can also escape. You know, we have Kroxa, which I think is going to be just really strong for us. And of course, Kroxa plus Lazav is a nice combo. But we can escape Kroxa from the graveyard. We can escape Woestrider from the graveyard. You know, like, so if this, you know, Woestrider dies, we can bring it back whenever we play a longer game. I'm not so sure about this Thassa's Intervention, but the person that played it likes it a lot. They actually have a couple. I took out one for a Carnival Carnage for best of one, with Carnival being a good cheap removal spell, but then also Carnage being a nice discard thing to kind of pair with Kroxa and Thought Erasure and everything like that, and you know, help clear the way for Nicol Bolas or Ashiok in the five mana slot. Should be a fun one to play, so let's see how it does. Usually these mid-range decks like this aren't as good in best of one, but we're just kind of trying out a bunch of stuff. Like, this is probably a better best of three deck than best of one deck. Of course, you need a sideboard, but we're just going to be trying this in best of one. Okay, we'll take this start. Got the new rat sleeves. We can take that, because we can play like Thought Erasure on turn two, and then Kroxa or Triton on turn three, or just another Thought Erasure on three. Oh, thanks. Thanks, Yad. Another Birth of Miletus, which I don't really care about, so we'll take... I mean, do I even care about Sarkhan? Not really. I guess I'll take it. Banishing Lights. Is it good to have two Kroxas? Probably. Yeah, we can have the Triton just attack through the walls, which is fine. I can also just ritual sit away the walls if I feel like it. Alright, so Woe Strider or the other two? I will take the other two. Woe Strider can just be in the graveyard, that's perfectly fine. Perfect. Get rid of those things. Get rid of that thing.
Watch this.
We'll just play this. Don't need another land. Hey, Danny. Thanks for the Twitch Prime sub. Glad you're enjoying all the videos on YouTube and anything. And thanks for the well wishes. It's our fifth sub of the day. That's it. Victory. All right, we're 1-0. Yeah, having Temple of Malice, I think, is pretty nice for Grixis, because I definitely want like as many black lands as possible, and so yeah, having Temple of Malice now I think has been a nice upgrade for him. All right, so we can Fabled Passage for Island right away, so we can have Island Swamp for turn two Thought Erasure. Or we can just Temple. You missed the first game? Yeah, that's... And we were playing against a control deck also. Take the Cavalier of Thorns. But this Hydroid Krasis could be pretty annoying to deal with. So I know Carnival would kill the Risen Reef, but I want to use Bedevil because I want to use Carnage to get rid of their hand. Now an untap land would be nice. Thank you. Carnival Carnage is sweet. Talk about an underrated card. Card's sweet. Oh, that was bad. I should be playing... Oh, whatever, that's fine. I should be playing the Mire Triton first, obviously. But worked out. I wanted them to keep a spell in hand that would be able to Thought Razor away.
Let your weak minds crumble.
Sure. I'll just kill a Leafkin Druid. Perfect. I wanted them to scry during my turn here so I can break it up with the Enter the God Eternals. Oh, they scryed them both to the bottom anyway. Well. I guess I should have milled myself. All right, lesson learned, just always mill yourself. Lesson learned. At 8 now.
You are over.
I think Carnage won us that game. That and Thought Erasure. This is a tough Fabled Passage. I'm not gonna mull again, but this deck has a whole lot of lands. It has 27. There we go. Ooh, the Lazav Kroxa combo. But obviously I need to get to Ritual of Soot. I think I just put it to the bottom. Gains indestructible. I don't like that. Probably still just cast Ritual of Soot. Let's see, it gets rid of one Owl Seed and the Karametra's Blessing. Because then I can play. Then it's easier for me to play like Woestrider. You know, still taking a 2-for-1. Well, obviously now I'm just gonna play the Lazav. Sure, I'll take Thought Erasure. Thought Erasure will pair with making Kroxa next turn. All right, Grixis midrange. We're doing it. The God Eternals is pretty good. I'll keep it. It's not like Ritual is so good. Looks like we're playing against Mono White Formation. So we're going to try to kill all these things one by one, which is going to be kind of difficult. Do I just play Bonecrusher Giant as is next turn? Oh no. Alexodon. Ugh. Ouch. That oh man, I should not have kept that Ashiok. Alexodon. I can't be Alexodon from here. Ouch. Ouch. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I mean, I guess I have to play this thing. Thank you.
Luxodon got me.
All right, so we're 3-1. These sleeves are from the secret lair that just came out today. The rat secret lair. So we'll Fabled Passage for swamp. No, that doesn't work. I guess just Temple Island. That's true. We did not play Fires into Clarion. That's true. We did not. We did not have Fires Invention and Sweeper. Yeah, to build a collection, the most efficient way is probably playing Limited. But I know not everybody likes to play Limited. And so then maybe for you, so it's also kind of an individual thing, like if you want to buy packs and everything, that's perfectly fine too. So I think carnivaling this thing is like the best way to get rid of that, but I also don't really want to. Don't really want to just like have my turn two only spending one mana with how the hand is. I guess I ran into that. That makes my life worse. Now I wish I would have just led with Kroxa. That makes my life worse. Do they have a pump spell? I guess they could. They could have Collision Colossus, I guess. Nope. Okay. So I guess I need to get the red source so that I have two red for bringing back Crocs. But I need another black for it anyway. I'll just get the red. I think we're fine with that. That's fine. So I hope they draw a 3-mana or less creature, hopefully not one with haste, and then I get to just play Steam Vents Ritual Assault next turn. If not, I'll probably just go Carnival, kill the Knight, and Bonecrusher Giant. I guess I could still just play Ritual Assault, because the thing, if I play Bonecrusher Giant first, then like never casting this soot. That's fine. Needs five other cards. Probably play something eventually. Or not. Lazav. Well, that surveil, I could have brought back Kroxa, but we'll just have the Lazav activation. And they're dead. So we'll be 4-1. Lazav Kroxa is a really good combination. I think Sultai is also pretty good with Lazav. You know, just Lazav and the other Elder Giant, Uro. Yeah, they just had Ambush and Embercleave. And we're 4-1. GG's. Oh, mana doesn't look so good here. 27 land deck, and we're on the draw. I think we'll keep the 2 lander and the 27 land deck on the draw. We need to draw a blue source and a black source. So, first draw, Temple of Deceit. Close. Yeah, Lazav keeps his name, so you can have Lazav and Kroxa in play. Teferi, Fae, Dance. Well, unfortunately, we have a very anti-aggro hand here with Scorn Soot from playing against Control.
No, I am not making this up as I go.
I don't know. Seem like you're making it up to me. It's good getting some cards in the graveyard for Kroxa. MTG needs a unicorn tribal five color deck. Hey, Brainfly. Yeah, it looks like maybe I should have just bedeviled the Teferi on turn three with them, being at five loyalty.
I've got time.
Guess I should have just done that the first time.
I am not going to sit this way out. This might be a bad idea.
All right, well, we got the dance out of there. They're probably bouncing the Othakaya. No, not bouncing Othakaya. Wish we wouldn't have drawn another ritual set. The term aristocrats comes from Return to Ravnica standard, really from Cartel Aristocrat, from that card, but then also Falcon Wrath Aristocrat. There was basically an aristocrats deck before. What it means is to have, basically an aristocrat deck is a deck with smaller creatures that you sacrifice and gain value from sacrificing your own creatures. Yeah, I mean, Teferi can bounce Kroxa. Not much for me to do about that.
Dream big tonight.
That's more like it. Here we go.
I'm glad they ticked up and didn't put another card into their hand so I can kill the Fae of Wishes. Which I was planning to do with the Ritual of Soot to get that out of my hand and just get rid of the O4 also. But then us having the ability to get rid of the Teferi, I went with that. Okay. Yeah, they kind of got rid of the wrong one, but... that's good. Trade a... you know, we'll trade a Ritual of Soot for a... you know, a Dance with the Mance any day. Yeah, that's their second dance. We discarded one earlier, or... yeah, we made them discard one earlier. No Fae of Wishes. Bad. Hey, what's up, Ascaria? Thanks for the Twitch Prime sub. Ugh, I need more red mana. Because I want to play Kroxa and then the new Kroxa. Make them discard both cards. I'm just going to play this one so that I get to activate Castle. Yeah, I bottomed all the red mana before. Or... got rid of his defense there. Oh. That's how it goes.
Trust me. You'll thank me later. Let's try this.
An aggressive Oath of Kaya. Ascaria is our sixth of the day. I'll update that. And Etter Ramirez staying on the 3-month streak. Number 7. Thank you, Edder. Bunch of re-subs today. Thanks, Wayward Wanderer. They kept one on top, and so they just kept a land to just draw a land, so I'd whiff on the land. Because whatever spell they keep, I would take. Omen of the Sea Scry. Thanks, cool team. Yeah, it's true. Storm's Wrath doesn't kill Kroxa, but it kills lots of other stuff. And hurts our planeswalkers and everything. I think Ritual of Sit's good. I think I like Ritual of Sit.
Trust me,
more.
I have a plan.
The Ritual of Sit did win us like that game against Jeskai as we like killed a bunch of their stuff and my Atria stayed alive. Should have just drawn. Would have had the mana to play Nicol Bolas, but now I don't. We're doing a good job getting, you know, like our, you know, scryed a whole bunch of stuff to the bottom that we don't want to draw. We're doing a good job with the scries. They should be bouncing Oath of Kaya to kill Atreus. That's what I assume they're going to be doing, at least. Yeah, Drown in the Lock could work in this deck. Drown in the Lock's just a really strong card. I don't really want to enter the God Eternals. Right? Yeah, I'd much rather have those cards. Yeah, just always take the two cards. It's a safe bet.
I'll protect you.
Yeah, they tried to get me. Tried to get me to take the Enter the God Eternals. Honestly, maybe I should be keeping the Ritual of Soot. To protect against Dance. Actually, I probably should just be keeping that. Yeah, I probably should just be keeping that. Oh, I needed to tap the castle. Now I can't play Dragon God. Whoops. I guess I'm playing Kroxa. I'm kind of assuming I'm going to get land here, though. Alright, what do they have? They have 26 cards left in library. I kind of want to take this into the God Eternals. Mill them over four more. Yes, we got another dance. Perfect. How many dances do you think they play? Think they play four? We got three. Three Fae of Wishes and three dances gone. Dang, y'all are all saying that you think they have four. I should have kept that Ritual of Sit. I really regret that. Regret that. That decision probably cost me this game. Yep. Yeah, that was the wrong decision, getting rid of that ritual set. Kind of just did it instinctively, you know, like, oh, control, let's get rid of this. And then right after I discarded it, I was saying I should not have discarded that. It was just kind of an instinct that popped up. Yeah, it's going to be this Saturday, Mink. It was, I think I should have discarded Lazav. I don't think I really need Lazav, honestly. That's what I should have discarded. I want a castle? I guess so. Yes. Yes, Hatred. I am purchasing a house. Well, I wanted to get more. Yeah, I wanted to get the two Leafkin Druids, but oh well. I'm buying the house. I'm buying it in Texas. In Denton, Texas. Yeah, we kind of need the lands, so we'll take those. And speaking of lands, they do not have any on their side. Vardisk. Thank you, Vardisk. Vardisk? And another Twitch Prime sub in here. Y'all are awesome. Hey, Frizzer. Nice. Good luck, Mink. I think I'm just going to Woe Strider. I'd want to play Mire Triton first if I would go Mire Triton. Cavalier Thorns and Risen Reef are both rough. I mean, so is Agent of Treachery. I don't know how I'm beating this stuff. I need to stop auto-tapping so bad. I just gotta hope they don't draw a land. Never mind. That was the hope. They didn't draw a land to be able to play that card. Now it's over. Yeah, I don't really have any chance here. Yep. Cavalier Thorns is really good. Should have taken that, I guess, with that third Thought Erasure instead of the Risen Reef, but I thought my best chance of winning that game was them not drawing land for a few turns, but they did draw land, and so I lost. All right, so I ended up 4-3. Lost the last two. Simic's tough to beat whenever they have all those cards. That's just going to be a deck that's hard to beat with mid-range stuff. I don't really mind that loss. We did beat Simic before when we were able to discard all their hand first. The carnage was awesome, but this time they were stuck on lands, and so they had just tons and tons of spells. Last time, you know, they drew a lot more lands, and that was a lot better for us. Yeah, the Esper match, I regret discarding that Ritual of Soot. Right after I did it, I knew I should not have discarded that Ritual of Soot. But, oh well, I did. But yeah, so that was Grixis Midrange. That was pretty fun to play. Lazav, Kroxa were awesome. The Woe Strider was not impressive. And honestly, the Triton didn't do a ton for us, but we didn't play against a lot of aggro. The Triton certainly helps out against aggro. Thought Erasure was amazing. But yeah, I'd have to say that probably the Woe Strider was the card I liked the least. Did feel like we could have used some more counter magic. And, you know, just kind of in general, like if Woe Striders were just like Ionize, I would have preferred that. I think with Grixis, I think you want a little bit of counter magic. You know, you don't need like tons, but I think it's good to have a little bit. All right, but there we go. That's Grixis midrange. So we got four other decks to get to. So those of y'all watching this video later on, let me know what you think of the deck. You know, hit that like button over there. Leave those comments. I'd appreciate both of those. But thank you so much for watching some Grixis midrange, and I will see you for the next video.